1995, 4 years after the fall of the USSR, NASA decides to send its astronauts to train on Russia's Mir space station.
NASA, of course, understands perfectly that Mir is very important as a first step toward the International Space Station.
Due to the history between the two Cold War rivals, the missions are under intense pressure.
The public and the Congress are very skeptical about cooperation with the Russians. Cold War, of course, is still in the memory of many people.
One of the astronauts chosen to work on Mir is Jerry Leninger. In February 1997, he is joined by two Russian cosmonauts and a German.
So we're all just sitting around, eating dinner. I grab some dehydrated borscht, depart, go to do some work in a different module.
At 10:35 p.m., the Mir space station's master alarm suddenly goes off.
Master alarm means you're having a really bad day in space. Vasily Sablayev comes flying fast around the corner. I said, "Is it serious?" And he said, "Yes, very. Fire." We've got a flame coming out 3 or 4 feet in length, blowtorch-like in intensity, sparks flying off the end of it, coming out of an oxygen canister.
Within seconds, the whole module fills with toxic fumes.
I grab the respirator off the wall, full rubber mask over my head, activate the oxygen canister, breathe in, and I get nothing.
The respirator has failed. Leninger has to survive on the oxygen stored in his blood until he can get to another.
I think to myself, gotta get to that next respirator. And to be honest with you, I wasn't sure where that next respirator was.
The superheated flame begins to eat into the structure of the space station.
And I see what looks to be a ball of wax being splattered against the far bulkheads. Realize it's not balls of wax, it is molten metal. This thing is firing molten metal across, gonna pierce the hull. Right there, I say, we have to get that fire out or we're gonna lose our lives and we're gonna lose this space station. Thinking about my son, I yelled out, "Goodbye, John. You know, looks like I'm not gonna be making it back." I said goodbye to my wife. Starting to feel as if I'm sort of underwater. Starting to get a little fuzzy peripheral vision from needing oxygen.
Blinded by smoke, Leninger has to feel his way to a working respirator.
Breathe in, and I get oxygen. Hyperventilate the next 30, 40 seconds, get my blood oxygen level back up. And then I just scream, "We're gonna get that fire out. Gonna see my boy again."
Leninger and Valerie Kortzun attempt to tackle the blaze with Mir's fire extinguishers.
That flame has intensity. Exhaust 3 fire extinguishers. I'm finally heading in there with a 4th fire extinguisher. And then Vasily just screams, "Jerry, fire's out." Adrenaline really flowing. Big sigh of relief when that flame is out.
It's the worst fire to ever happen in Earth's orbit. The crew manages to film the aftermath, but key information about the blaze is withheld from NASA.
All communication is via Mission Control Moscow. There was no direct communication to anyone down at NASA. So we had to indirectly kind of hint at the seriousness of what's going on.
The Russian Space Agency tells NASA the fire was a minor incident, lasting just 90 seconds.
On the Russian side, there is a tendency to make this accident sound and look not as dangerous and terrible as it really is.
The following day, the Russian version of events begins to unravel.
When Tony Tsang, the U.S. operations leader in Moscow, arrives at work, he's kept in the dark for a while. It's not until he overhears a conversation in Russian that he realizes the full extent of the problem and the fire that has occurred.
To get the truth to Earth, Leninger has to ask a departing cosmonaut to smuggle a letter to his wife.
We had Valeri take one of my notes and stuff it in a spacesuit and kind of told her the seriousness of the fire.
And it describes the entire situation, including the fact that the fire lasts 14 minutes, not the seconds that the Russians claim.
Since 1995, NASA has invested $400 million in Mir. When the U.S. government hears about the Russian cover-up, they demand a full inquiry into safety levels on board the space station. NASA appoints Special Agent Joe Gunheitz to lead the investigation.
Congress wants answers. There's a lot of money involved in the Mir, and there's risk that may be unacceptable.
Gunheitz uncovers evidence of several previous safety breaches on Mir.
The Russians were not being honest with us. They weren't telling us about prior fires. NASA didn't know that there was a fire on October 15, 1994, involving the same issue.
NASA's financial stake in Mir means it stores copies of all mission safety briefings at Johnson Space Center. But when Gunheitz tries to access his evidence, he is told it is no longer there.
On March 14th, it was determined that 37 tapes were missing. These tapes were a no-holds-back account about the dishonesty of the Russians, the dangers of the fire.
With key evidence missing, Gunheitz has to find another way to get to the truth.
What I need to do is talk to the individuals and find out what was said. I was able to reconstruct the tapes. The inconvenient truth about how dangerous the Mir actually was.
The evidence suggests the Russian Space Agency has been systematically covering up safety issues on Mir.
This was their cash cow. The Russians knew that if the American public knew how dangerous the Mir was, they could not endorse our continued presence on the Mir.
The inquiry following the fire traces the incident to a faulty oxygen canister.
A comprehensive investigation reveals that the fire was caused by a piece of latex glove caught in the oxygen canister. How it got there, nobody knows.
The crew only lived because of quick, decisive action by Leninger and his Russian crewmates.
It's a matter of split seconds, life and death. You make the wrong decision, that can get you further down a spiral you don't want to go down.
America's partnership with Russia survived the incident, and Mir went on to lay the foundations for the International Space Station. But some say distrust still lingers between the former Cold War enemies.
I think it is a miracle that the crew survived, but it's even bigger miracle that the space station did not have to be abandoned.